Being a data scientist is cool, but sometimes it's overrated. Today, let's talk about the most underrated job in data science, and it's in way higher demand than a data scientist. I'm Samanvay, a data scientist living in Sydney, Australia. Data science is huge and growing really rapidly, especially in Australia. There are many roles that you can do in data science. You could be a data scientist, a machine learning engineer, a data engineer, or a data analyst. Today, let's talk about the most underrated job in data science. And I'm honestly surprised as to why it doesn't get enough airtime. Feel free to pause the video and write down your guesses in the comment section below. So without further ado, let's talk about the role itself. So if you guessed data engineer, then give yourselves a pat on the back, because that's the correct answer. According to a data science interview report done by interviewquery.com, in 2020, there was a 40% increase in data engineering interviews, as opposed to only 10% increase in data science interviews. In another tech job report done by Dice, data engineer was listed as the fastest growing profession, with a 50% year-on-year growth, as opposed to a 32% year-on-year growth for a data scientist. Now let's talk about what data engineering is and why it's in such a high demand right now, to the point that it's now more popular than the sexiest job of the 21st century, being a data scientist. I actually started my career doing a lot of data engineering, so I'll be speaking greatly from my data engineering experience and also relating to the trend that I'm seeing in the industry and throughout my career so far. Firstly, what does a data engineer do? In summary, a data engineer looks at how data is collected, transformed, and loaded. Data engineers will readily build scalable data systems that execute on these three domains. And let's talk about why these skills are in such high demand right now. So the trend that we're seeing in the industry is that more and more organizations are reaching higher levels of data sophistication. With this comes the need to build reliable data systems that won't falter when it's being pushed to the limit. And more organizations are dealing with a greater amount of data, and this is only set to increase going into the future. This explains why there's a huge demand for data engineers that are well-versed in building robust data systems. Now let's talk a little bit about the specific task that a data engineer does, so it gives you a little bit more detail as to what a data engineer's day-to-day looks like. As I mentioned, data engineers are concerned with data collection, data transformation, and data loading. So what do I mean by data collection? An example of this is integrating with third-party data providers in order to ingest their data into our databases. Let's suppose that you're a data engineer that's working at a company that provides personalized news feeds based on the user preferences. The first step is to get the news. This involves connecting with existing news providers and downloading their news so that you can build a recommendation system. In more detail, the data engineer will be responsible for building ingestion pipelines that hook into the APIs of these news websites and ingesting their data into databases. And the data engineer will be responsible for setting up the entire system. So hopefully you can see how data collection is such a crucial role and how important it is with data of all kinds in all different types of industries. So after you've connected to these news websites, you've downloaded the data. So next step is data transformation. So you might realize that the different data sources from the different news websites are not standardized, and they're all in different data formats. And this difference in data format can cause a lot of issues down the line, as data analysts and data scientists are looking to use that data for their model building or reporting purposes. So your role as a data engineer is to create a uniform data model for all of the different data formats. So that's where the data transformation step comes in. So this will involve you doing a lot of data cleaning and building transformation pipelines for this purpose. Then the final step is data loading. Once you've transformed the data, then you need to make the data ready for use by data scientists and data analysts. So for example, in the case of data analysts, they might want to analyze the data, which means that you might have to build another pipeline that's able to take that transformed data and shift it into an analytics tool. This might be Looker or Power BI or even Tableau. So you need to make sure that the data is easily ingestible by users down the line. Another example of this data loading process is loading your data into another data system or loading it into another software platform that the customer will be directly interacting with. So this entire process I've just described is known as ETL, extract, transform, and load. The main responsibility of a data engineer is to take care of that ETL process, and this might involve them working on all of the pieces of the pipeline as long as everything that's needed to facilitate it, such as curating a database, to making data integrations, to coming up with effective data models. So what kind of tools does a data engineer use on a day-to-day basis? So the main programming languages that a data engineer uses would be Python and SQL. So all of the ETL pipelines are usually written in Python. Sometimes data engineers also use Scala to create effective data pipelines. In my experience, I've also done quite a bit of work in Golang to make APIs for data systems, but that can be on a case-to-case basis. In terms of applications, you'll be using Git for source control, using tools like Kubernetes, Docker, and cloud technologies such as AWS and Google Cloud Platform for deploying applications. You might also use ETL pipelining tools like Airflow or event streaming tools like Apache Kafka or Beam. And finally, you might use Snowflake or Looker for your data analytics and building bespoke data products. This is obviously not an exhaustive list, but hopefully you get a good idea as to what are the tools that data engineers use on a day-to-day basis. So who should become a data engineer? So I'd definitely recommend you to become a data engineer if you truly love programming and software engineering. So to be a great data engineer, you definitely have to have a great attention to detail, because majority of the time you'll be in the weeds of building data systems and also looking at a lot of data in its more granular and detailed form. So in that case, you have to be very good at picking up anomalies and errors in the data. Like I mentioned before, you also need a good grasp of software engineering fundamentals. And on the flip side, you won't be interacting too much with customers or stakeholders, definitely not as much as data scientists. So data engineers will definitely be spending more time coding as opposed to data scientists. So you've decided you want to be a data engineer, so what other steps you can take to head down that direction? So if you're just graduating from high school, then I'd recommend you to do a computer science or a software engineering degree to be a data engineer. And it's also pretty useful if you choose to do a data science major, because that'll expose you to the data science cycle and really understand how data scientists think about data and how machine learning algorithms work. There are also some data science degrees that are very heavy on the engineering side of things, but in my opinion right now, I think it's best to stick with pretty vanilla software engineering or computer science degrees, because that'll give you the fundamentals that you need to grow as a data engineer. Now let's talk about the spicy details, which is what is the salary of data engineers? So currently in Australia, the average salary is around 110,000 to 120,000 AUD. And that number varies obviously based on your experience and the industry that you're in. Going into the future, I can definitely see the demand for data engineers only increasing. So that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, then smash that like button and I'll see you next time.